don't know what happened to the other guys. I told Nick to meet me here over an hour ago. Anyway, tonight I'm at the Siren nightclub where they're launching Southside Records. The Upper Hutt Posse have just come off stage. It's a label that's aiming to put out a lot of South Auckland rap and black music. And good luck to them. While we wait for the other guys to show up, let's take a look at two other local bands who've been doing quite good business over the last few months in Auckland. First up, the Hallelujah Picassos, whose tape Taxi Driver you can go out and buy now, and Drone, whose debut album came out this year.
Two parts really. There's sort of a natural sort of pop sort of feeling to it, I suppose, crossed over with parts of classical, contemporary classical music. So we're perhaps influenced by people like Steve Reich, Philip Glass, but at the same time we're influenced by, you know, more contemporary sort of electric bands. But at the same time, there's a real sort of industrial sort of sound to what we do too. One performance might be more oral orientated, another one, the visual side of it could be just as important.
Sometimes you can put more ideas into the record sound-wise than we can actually play because there's only three of us.
Yeah, that's the point. Yeah.
So with our samples and things, there's often more in the records than what we actually play live.
In a pub, people find it unusual because there's cellos and violin and we're sort of using a performance type nature. But in galleries and performance spaces, people find it difficult as well because we're using, you know, voluminous electric guitars, bass, percussion, you know, it's sort of, so it's quite a difficult thing, and sometimes we can end up not really catering to anyone's tastes.
The first tour that we did was for 6 weeks, and we took our own PA and everything in the trailer and went to little small places like Barrytown on the west coast.
Clyde.
People are quite receptive because they don't get much.
The first major tour, we were under no illusions, you know, pulling in a lot of people or anything, obviously. And we took it as a sort of a holiday, and it was a good chance to visit the west coast of the South Island and places like that. It was really important to do that. And I think, like, when we go overseas next year, if, you know, which is what we are going to attempt to do, we're going to take the same attitude that it's, you know, going to be a holiday that we'll play as well.
River, sea.